Alright, there we go. Welcome back to another episode of Crackdown Campaign. So for the time being, while we wait for our next trial, because our next trial is going to be a nice little surprise, but if it's going to be outside of the district, we're just going to stay within the district until this district is done. And then once that's done, we're going to go to number two. That's three, but two's over there. On that side. Okay? In today's episode, we are going to get the lowrider. Yes, we are. And then we're just gonna find, like, random cars. In this episode, we are gonna find random cars until our next trial is ready to go. But however, there's six more trials left on this district until the final trial, which I'm not gonna spoil that its location yet. Alright? So, what we're going to do is this. We're going to travel here. Okay? So, we're going to pick our guns. If I have any guns. Yeah. Where is them? Just kidding. Not that type of guns, but on the game. Let's see. We can do X80, SMG. We can do the cat, it could. At the same process, we are gonna go with those, but we are gonna travel here. Forgot to do so. We're gonna go to Los Muertos, and we're gonna go to Pacific City Bank. And yes, we are. My goodness. Excuse me. My bad. Really? What? Oh, here we go. Okay. Jose Tormento Guerra uses his failing nightclub on Los Muertos Southern Island to ply his vile trade. The manufacture and distribution of potent and addictive narcotic cocktail. My goodness, really? You're going to be doing that, mister? A cunning, cold-blooded character, Guerra takes deliveries of the drugs by day and deals them by night. His operation alone accounts for a significant percentage of Los Muertos' illicit income. Alright, so his location is very distinctive, very, very distinctive, very much so. Guerra's premium narcotics made his club a magnet for the city's more discerning criminals and civilians. Attendance recently plummeted, suggesting Guerra's up to something. A frontal assault requires speed, precision, to give gang members less time to aim. Use explosives to breach the club entrance gates. Efficient sniping can remotely reduce overall opposition and minimize your risk of injury. We do not have either the rifle guns. We do not have neither. We need to get those at some point. Alternative access is possible through the club's park. What did I just say? Never mind. Alternative access is possible through the club's car park via the coastal road. This is well guarded, so expect strong opposition. Once inside, keep moving. Gang reinforcement is plentiful, and space is tight. Yeah, I've seen this particular field, this particular area. It's very, very much, very tight, very not, you won't successfully get through this really easy, to be honest with you. Further access at the rear of the club is possible by swimming in or jumping from the rocks at the marina. This route should take you very close to Gera and present negligible opposition until you reach the heart of the club. Advanced tactical profiling suggests that entering the club from the front or upper levels will send Gera running for the rear side of the car park. Reaching the base from the lower levels should encourage him to move to his VIP lounge. So either way, if I come from the front, he's gonna go to the rear. Make sense? So if I come from the back, he's gonna stay and move to his VIP lounge. And I will show you that in this trial on the next episode. Because in today's episode, we're going to collect cars as we go. Okay? which he is not that far from our exact location to keep in mind. Okay. Ow. But am I able? Yes. Awesome. Let's go ahead and collect this right now. There we go. Done. Now, our ability here is going to be very simple and very tactical. Is that what I think that is? Is that the lowrider? No, it is not. Lowrider is actually a little bit different from that. Tad different from that. So it's very tad different. That is, I don't think that's a lowrider, but it's very close to that, really. It really is. So our first car, our very first car that we are definitely going to find is the lowrider. But we could, if we want, we can risk our lives getting the lowrider very close to our destination. But that could be risking our time and activating one enemy, which is that way. But I don't think it's possible to overcome that. And if you look at my tips and tricks video of how to get the lowrider after the fact you've defeated Valetta Sanchez, yes, if you actually defeated her, the cars will not be there. So finding these cars on the streets is very remote. But it's key to actually collect them before you take out the entire district. Keep that in mind. You'll be very lucky to run into it, but that vehicle right there, it is not. I think that's a caravan or like a SUV van or something. I don't recall by it remembering of its name, but it's very close to that, really. So getting the lowrider, something else. So if you looked at my previous episode on this campaign, go take a look at it, because I actually got myself, let's go, bring it on, this is what I'm looking for, right here, bring it on, alright, now, getting, getting this to its destination without running into a lot of people is very minimal. So you, since I just took out the tires, and I'm unable to carry it though. I'm very unable to carry this. So I really want to be careful and not run into enemies on the way. Because I really don't want to, hey, don't you dare. Alright. Come on, peeps. Out of my way. I don't wanna... No. Get out of the way. Ah, you kidding me, right? I can't even turn this. Especially when an officer is on my butt, you know? It's so nerve-wracking. But when I do get this car right where I need it, come on, dude, stop. Oh, my goodness. You're really making it tough for me, officers. Seriously. You really are making it tough for me. It already is damaged already as it is. Don't need any more damage. I'm already close to my destination. So getting it right where I need it. Okay, now the officers are now off of me, finally. Ugh. So I got the lowrider. Finally, for the most part. Alright. But let me tell you, that was nerve-wracking. Now, getting it inside the agency is going to be... And I'm unable to carry it. I need to get stronger, at least for the most part. Alright, come on. Alright, don't destroy this while I'm getting it inside. Get out of my way. See, here's the thing. controlling it inside this is going to be something. Now I'm safe inside. Hang on. Alright, now I just needed to get it up this hill without destroying it as it is. Because it's pretty bad. Safely getting it right here. Ladies and gentlemen, I am now housing a nice lowrider. If it is, that is. Alright, let's get out of that. Lowrider, please, let it be. Yes! Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, take pics. I'll give you some time to do it. To take some pics of it. Three, two, one. All right, here we go. So we took care of that. Now let's find another vehicle that we can actually pick up exclusively. Okay, now in order to do so, we are gonna go inside here and then go ahead and wheel ourselves out of here. But I am again going to go ahead and leave this vehicle right with the other one, so I am able to get back in and out with it, if I'm precisely about that. But I can only drive one car at a time. Look at that, I got some driving skills just from killing those enemies. Precise, huh? That's pretty good. Now, what are you doing over there? What are you doing? Wow, do you guys see that? You guys seen that, right? Oh my goodness. That back, no, wait. No, that's not an enemy. Good. Alright. So I'm gonna drive this car all the way over here and do that. Alright, I'm gonna get out of here. Alright, this is not a vehicle we can pick up randomly. But if we go over here, though, we could pick up this car right here. Now, I do need to get stronger, though. I really do, to be honest. So getting stronger will allow me to pick up cars. I don't know how strong you need to be. I really don't, to be honest. I think it's like either 2 or 3. Not really 100% certain on that. But I do know, as a matter of fact, that you have to be strong enough, though. Like, I think 2 or 3. Not very certain of that. But this car, in this episode today, we're going to get at least a couple cars, at least, for the most part. At least 2 or 3. And then call it a day. This is actually not any gang member type of car of any type. This is actually, as a matter of fact, civilian car. So, I'm able to pick this car just off from the street and leave it in the garage. It will be impounded. Alright, here we go. Let's get out of that car and done. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a secondary car, and it's called Microcar. Save the pictures for only gang-related, please. So, I am going to, now, even though I'm a 1-star, now I wonder if I'm able to get out safely. Like, able to get out. I wonder if I'm able to get out perfectionately. Not there. Let me try somewhere else. All right. But I do remember something, though. I really do, to be honest. Down in here, I would hate to get stuck in there. But even though there's water there, then yeah. Alright, I'm able to climb off of that. That's pretty good. Now, since I'm able to come out here, where are those hidden orbs at? Now, since I may have to climb somewhere, I need to climb at least somewhere. Now since I'm able to come out here, there's a hidden orb right here. There's a couple of those out here. So you want to be very, very cautious and very be aware of where they're at. This, however, you're unable to reach or get into if you're down here, that is. I do, however, we'll be able to... Dang it. There we go. Now I'm able to climb back up, but there is actually another orb nearby. Not very close. But it's close. I know it is. So you're gonna go over here. You're basically gonna circulate all the way around, in case you miss one. Cause sometimes if you overlook a spot, you may have to look inside and out. Pretty much almost everywhere, you know what I'm talking about. So finding these orbs, though, is something. So, I think I'm able to jump that right there. I think I am. Not 100%. That might be a little too high, but let's give it a shot. Yeah, it's too high. Can't do it. Being me, 1-star, can't do it. But to make things a little faster, hit the jump button and swim. All the way around. I think that might be the only one nearby on the outside. I think so. really 100% certain that is indeed, but there is one more outside, actually, if you think about it. To get to this one, I believe it's on that little ledge right over there, if I believe it is. But getting to it is something else. But I am going to say that until I'm actually either 2 or 3 star. Huh? Alright, so I'm able to do a full circle, I think I did. It's always good to do a full circle if you're not sure if you've covered almost anything. So, the way back in is right here. So you climb up, or jump up if you can, that is. There we go. But if you actually take a look, my running speed though is increased, but not by much. But you'll see, as my agility skill will be increased depending on how many of the agility orbs you get. So depending on how many you get can really result of how much you can get and how far you get the speed. Alright. Able to get up here though. If you pay attention though, if you come around like about, I would say right here, you will hear a very distinctive sound from the hidden orb. They have a very, very, very distinctive sound. If you pay attention, you'll see it, but not from the side, because it's actually behind it. If you actually pay attention, you'll see it, but not conclusively. It's like right behind. I'll show you in a minute here. Right up there. Right there, you see it? That little faint glow at the top of that. So, getting that. Okay, so we're getting a incoming... Oh, so Raphael, awesome. However, we have 2 enemies to deal with. Maybe on the next episode, possibly. As of at this point, I'm unable to get that. So I need to be at least 2 or 3 to get that. I am going to go ahead and take my time and, do a little swimming, but with some jumping. And I'm running into one of the trials, actually. So, avoiding that is good. So, taking your time can result many things when you're playing this. To be honest with you, yeah, takes a lot of time. Timing your jumps can save your life one day and get yourself out of danger pretty quick. So I'm able to get on land without hesitation. It took me about over a minute just from the agency, the keep, all the way to this land. Within, over a minute. That's not bad. So, thereby. We still have... What? Okay, so it must have went back or something. Interesting. said I am going to get some cars. Not by random, but I'm going to wait until shooting at me? Alright. So I'm gonna wait until I have ability of access to all these one of these cars at least for the most part. Because one of those, all of those actually, except for that truck, is a gang related car. So once I collect it, your goal is to take a photo of it if you can. Okay? So I'm making a mark on the gang, which is good. But I do want to help these guys out because they're running low on reinforcements. So there's one behind here. You can see that, right? Alright. But they will congratulate you if you're nearby. So just keep in mind, if you're nearby, they'll give you like a thumbs up or wave the gun at you. You know, don't be alarmed, don't shoot. They're just congratulating you. Keep that in mind. Just because they are just doing, you're just doing your job and you're helping out. That's all it is. So I am going to pick up some ammo here. On the same process. Which car should I take? This car? Should I take this? Oh, you know what? They actually are the same exact car. So, oh my goodness. So really, not much of a choice, really. So, taking the car. All right. So we're gonna go ahead and this car though is pretty fast. So keeping it on the low side of speed allows it to be less damaged on the way. So this will be the last car for the remaining 2 minutes of the episode here. So slow it down as you enter if you're on a very fast speed. So you want to be very slow when you're coming in on a hot speed, so you want to keep on that on the low side for speed wise when you're coming in. Alright, here we go. Ding. Freight cars, done. And this is Modify Saloon. Photos if you can. In 3, 2, 1, photo shoot done. So, if you didn't get a chance to take a photo of it, like I always say, pause it and then take photos. Go for it. I don't care. It's a video. Just do it. if I was counting and you brought out your phone and I took it off, you want to pause it before that happens. Because I only give you 10 seconds for each photo shoot. Keep that in mind. 10 seconds. So that you have at least enough time to bring out phones, any device, to bring some photos. So that you have at least a photo from my channel. And show it to people that this guy on this video has gotten the car that I wanted. Do it. That'll give everybody a chance to look at my videos. There you go. There's something you can do. Anyhow, I'm still, as of this point, I'm still unable to reach that. So I need to be at least 2 stars just to reach that. So, so what else? Let's see. Alright. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this video. If you really enjoyed it, hit that like button below and also subscribe for more of this, and also hit that bell notification, or smack it if you can, that is, Until then, I'm your host, Survival Man 1, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.